see, then of course value on A is the same as value on C. Okay, so that's what we have. This equivalence relation. Then what we can do, we can consider classes of equivalence. So if I have this, then I have this set SF, set of classes. And maybe it's denoted differently, okay, it's denoted differently in your mind. Set, see, then we will later use this for factor rings and what. So this is S factorized by this relation, so it's set of classes. Now, of course, we have a mapping from S to S, this projection which takes every element to its class. And then we can manufacture a new function F bar from this to T. What is it? It does take an element here, a class, right? So F bar of class of S is equal to F of S. Of course, you have to check that it is well defined. Because if you pick other representative, maybe this value will be different. But of course, it doesn't happen. Because what is class of S? It's collection of all elements which give you the same value of your function as S. So all of this would be the same. Okay? So this is well-defined function. And what is the beauty of it? That if I consider function from S to F and this function, it is the same. Composition of these two functions is the same as function F. Or you remember I told you that if I draw a picture differently, I'll see a triangle, it will be what is called commutative triangle. This is, you know, longer to state than to prove and to understand. And they have even square here, but anyway, never mind that. Okay, we didn't talk about permutations, so we're not going to talk about permutations. After that, we skipped with you chapter 3, and we will come to it after the midterm, right? And we went to chapter 4. So what did we do in chapter 4? It was polynomials, but first we defined notion of a field. Now, if I ask you what is a field, will you tell me I don't remember? You remember what is a field?
It's a Schwinger ring, but it also has multiplicative inverse.
For every non-zero element.
For every non-zero element.
Of course, you have zero, you never want to invert. Okay. So, ring with division. Sometimes, by the way, fields are, that's the way they're called. Division rings. Okay. But that's basically preserved for some special cases. This field is more general notion. Division rings are used usually in some context when the object is also a vector space and finite dimension, but anyway. So we know what are fields, we have a bunch of examples. And what next we did? We considered polynomials or fields. So we have a field, we have a letter x. This is a set of all polynomials in variable x. So we have monomials, x n power 2, x n power 3, x n power 0, which is 1, right? X itself n power 1. And linear combinations with coefficients from your field, they're polynomials, they're quite familiar, yeah? Of course, you looked at polynomials with, say, integer coefficients, right? Rational coefficients, real coefficients. So it's really not important, you can take any field. And you have operations, addition and multiplication, which make out of this field a commutative ring, out of this object a commutative ring. It's certainly not a field, right? Because I cannot divide by x. 1 over x is not in my ring of polynomials. So it is a ring, but not a field. So that's an interesting ring, and then you can talk about, say, ideals of this ring, but probably it's much further. Okay. So what you can do, you can try to develop theory for this ring similar to theory of integers as far as factorization is concerned. You can divide with remainder, right? Now when you, last time when we were talking about integers, remainder, we know that it's remainder if it's smaller than divisor, right? How do we know that it's remainder when we divide by polynomial? When it is in some sense smaller, and what is the sense?
The degree is maybe smaller.
When degree is smaller, yeah. When degree is smaller, so we are measuring size by degree. Okay, so we have this, and we have this, the same situation, we have division algorithm, we have the same situation as with integers. So if remainder has degree smaller than degree of divisor, then it's unique. That's unique. Okay. Very good. Okay. Then we had a notion which replaced notion of prime number for polynomials, and it was irreducible polynomials. So it's different word, the same sense. Polynomial is irreducible if I cannot factor it in meaningful way. Meaningful way means that I want both factors to be of smaller degree. I don't want constants. And then similarly with prime number, with numbers, we have unique factorization theorem. It is not called fundamental theorem of anything, because notion of fundamental theorem of algebra is occupied with other theorem. But anyway, any polynomial is presentable as product of irreducible polynomials in essentially unique way. What I mean, up to reordering, and of course, up to multiplication by invertible elements, by units.
Mm-hmm.
The same, by the way, with integers. We just never think about it. I can think about 2, I can think about negative 2, right? Same thing.
Mm-hmm. When you say units, same thing as constants?
Constants, elements of your field, non-zero elements of your field,
mm-hmm.
or polynomials of 0 degree,
mm-hmm.
are units. They are all invertible.
Anything else included in that?
No.
Okay.
There are no other units. If polynomial has positive degree, its inverse is not a polynomial. And of course, 0 is not invertible. And what is degree of 0? What is degree of 0?
Negative infinity.
Good. Negative infinity. Okay, so we have some small things here, but okay. Then we were talking about notion, important notion of root of polynomial. Root of polynomial is some element, say, of this field would be a root of polynomial. If I plug it into my polynomial, make all computations, result is in my field now, right? Result is 0. So what we encounter, it's quite possible that polynomial doesn't have root in field F. No root. So what did we do if we don't have root? What did we learn is possible to do? Hmm? Nah.
Represented as a...
So if we have a polynomial without a root in this field F, then of course we cannot have root, it's not there. But what can we do with field F? We can enlarge it in such a way that larger field contains a root. And what we did with you, we discussed with you some very specific construction which make this enlargement. And the theorem which we had special name. It was named after a fellow who proved it. What was the theorem?
Gauss?
No. Not Gauss at all. Who was the guy?
Was it the guy who died in duel?
Kronecker, thank you. Yeah.
Speak up over there.
Thank you. Yeah, it was Kronecker. Okay. So I suspect it's time for us to call it quits, and we have Thursday when we proceed with it and with your questions. But then unfortunately after this Thursday we will have Tuesday. And then what will happen?
Yeah,
we'll have a test. Okay, now I have some homeworks which were checked but never taken back. Thomas, your homework.
So I thought the test was Tuesday from the syllabus.
Well,
from Thursday.
No, it's Tuesday.
Yeah.
Okay. The syllabus says reviewing tests for the week.
No, but what I want to have...
you mean you thought it was this Thursday?
Yeah, I want to have tests on Tuesday because this gives me a good opportunity to spoil your weekends. So Melissa disappeared, right? Melissa DeVries is not here. Okay. Lucas, please. Okay, here you go. Eric, Shell, and Frank. Okay, so we have all of this, and this young lady just is not here anymore. I think we're done for today. I think I'm done for today. Of course, I encourage you to go home and learn some mathematics. Okay, of course, goodbye.
Of course, yes.
I'm starting to get the idea he likes it. He likes it. You know what I mean? Starting to get that feeling.
Thanks.
I don't know. It's...
You don't think it was the 8 years of extended education beyond high school?
No, no.